Let's create a simple application that browses the list of drives on the computer, folders, and files. I've created a Windows Forms application with three lists. The first list, drive list, is going to contain a list of all the drives on the computer, like the C drive, the D drive, the E drive. When the user clicks one of those drives, it will show all the folders at the root of that drive. When the user clicks one of those folders, the program will list all of the files contained within that folder. First, we need to populate the drive list when the form opens. So I'm going to double-click the form to open up the form load event handler. First, I need to import the system.io namespace. This namespace contains all of the classes used for accessing the file system. Next, I'm going to use a for each loop within the form1load event handler. This loop is going to iterate through the collection produced by the driveinfo.getDrive static method. That returns a collection of drive info objects. So each one is going to be named DI. As I iterate through each of these, I'm going to add them to the drive list box, just by calling the items.add method. Back to the form, it's time for me to populate the folders list box when the user clicks a drive. I'm going to double-click drive list to open up the default event handler, which handles the selected index changed event. This event handler is called anytime the user selects a different item. First thing I need to do is to clear any items that already exist in the folders list box. Next, I'm going to create a try catch block. This is important here because if a user selects a drive that's not available, for example, a memory card reader that doesn't have a memory card inserted into it, it will throw an error. So in the event handler, I'm simply going to show the error in a message box. So within the try block, I'll actually do the work of listing all the subfolders. First, I need to create an instance of the drive info class that corresponds to the drive that the user selected. I'll call it drive. Now, to retrieve it, I'm going to use the directcast method. Directcast casts, which is another term for converts, a generic object into the type that we actually need. So to retrieve the selected item, I need to call driveList.selectedItem. Notice that I'm also specifying the class that it needs to be converted into. With this method here, directcast returns an instance of drive info. This will, for example, if the user clicks a C drive, this will create an instance of drive info that relates to the C drive. Now I can create a for each loop that iterates through the drive.rootDirectory.getDirectories method, which corresponds to all of the root directories for the drive. Within the for each loop, I need to add each of the directory info instances, which I called dir info, to the folders list. So the last thing I need to do is to populate the files list box whenever the user selects a folders list. So I'll double click this to again create a selected index changed event handler. As before, the first thing I need to do is to clear the items from the list. Now I'm going to create a directory info instance that relates to the selected directory. As before, I'm going to use directcast. one last for each loop. This time I'm going to iterate through the directory info.get files collection, which is a collection of file info objects. And add each one to the files list box. Now, if I did all this right, I should be able to run it and browse the contents of the C drive. Clicking C loaded the folders list box with all of the folders in the root of the C drive. I'll click the Windows folder, and the files list box now shows each of the files in my Windows folder.